The idea that you can play pre-recorded audio material in order to learn a language while you sleep has been around for quite some time. But where we decades ago had to deal with cassette tapes and not a whole lot of science to back it up with, things now look a bit different. With the rise of the internet, language sleep learning has enjoyed a renaissance, and only here on YouTube, channels selling this idea have hundreds of thousands of subscribers and millions of views. So let's have a closer look at the science and what we know today. Can you actually learn a language while you sleep? The answer is no, you cannot learn a language while you sleep. And if you think about it, that makes sense. Because after all, if it were possible, you would most certainly have heard more about it, since it would essentially revolutionize our entire society. But that aside, there are things to be said about the interaction of language learning and sleep. Okay, so the key thing about language learning and sleep is that you cannot learn new information when you're not awake. That means that in order to learn pronunciation, grammar, vocabulary, whatever it may be, it's necessary to be awake, since all of them require active learning, which is literally not possible when you're not conscious. However, while you cannot learn new things in your sleep, sleep is still one of the single most important things when it comes to the learning process. This is because while we learn new things during our waking hours, we consolidate these things to our memories when we go to sleep. In other words, when we learn a new word during the day, it's not until we fall asleep that we actually start to seriously commit it to our long-term memory. This is also the reason why sleep deprivation is one of the worst enemies to learning there is, and the reason why it's actually a good idea to take naps when studying, since any sleep you get will help you retain the information you've gained since last waking up. But while the effects of sleep on memory consolidation and by extension learning has been pretty established for quite a while, there's also a more recent hypothesis regarding how the brain actually does this, which may or may not have ramifications for how we can use sleep to our educational advantage. What I'm talking about is the active system consolidation hypothesis, which is one of the two main competing hypotheses regarding memory consolidation. Very simplified, this hypothesis assumes that newly acquired information is consolidated in the brain by being spontaneously replayed and reanalyzed during slow-wave sleep, also known as deep sleep. And the reason this could be relevant for us is because researchers have now started to experiment with trying to manually trigger certain memories by using cues such as sound or odor, with the aim that these memories be better consolidated later on. This method is called targeted memory reactivation, or TMR, and has been the topic of a small but increasing number of studies in the past half decade. And when you look at the people trying to sell the idea of sleep learning all around the internet, these are the studies that they will refer to as proof that their ideas work. Now, in a nutshell, what the researchers have done in these studies is this. 1. Gather participants and teach them, say, a bunch of words in a foreign language. 2. Divide them into different groups. Some will stay awake and do nothing. Some will stay awake and perform a task. Some will go to sleep and be left alone. And some will go to sleep and be subjected to TMR. 3. When the members of the TMR group have fallen asleep, check when they're in slow-wave sleep, and then replay the words or items that they've just learned back to them at certain intervals. 4. After an hour or so, when the first round of slow-wave sleep usually ends, wake everybody up and test them at how well they recall what they learned a few hours earlier. The results of these studies give two main things to highlight. First of all, the participants who got to sleep greatly outperformed those who had stayed awake, regardless of what they had been doing or been subjected to. Second of all, the participants who were subjected to TMR remembered about 10% more items than the participants who were left to sleep in peace. And there we have the key finding. By using TMR during slow-wave sleep, we can remember about 10% more of what we learned earlier. And while 10% more is not very revolutionizing, it's actually a really cool thing, because with seemingly no effort, we can suddenly get quite a significant improvement in the long term. But a hallmark of a good scientist is a healthy dose of skepticism, so now let me get to the part of this video where I play the negative guy. First of all, I want to underline that these studies have not proven anything. There are only a handful of studies on this subject, with quite small samples and narrow timeframes, and they have not been replicated or followed up to a degree where you would feel safe claiming this to be fact. Unfortunately, this mindset doesn't always sit too well with popular media, and so when the first main study came out and said, "Hey, we found something interesting here, this is probably worth looking into," the internet changed this into, "Hey everyone, we have proof of this now, let's go do it!" Yeah. And while there aren't really any reasons to believe that the results are wrong or misleading in this case, there are other issues that are worth taking into account before you start listening to a random selection of words every night. First up, and the most important one, we don't know if this might have any detrimental effects. There are studies that suggest that using TMR might result in a trade-off, where by enhancing certain memories, other memories end up taking a back seat in the consolidation process. We also don't know whether TMR will affect the quality of your sleep, or what the effects of long-term use are, positive as well as negative. Furthermore, most of us don't have any proper means of using TMR in our personal lives anyway. In order for it to work properly, we need a synthesis of sleep cycle tracking, volume adjustment, interval adjustment, and the right items of vocabulary and grammar to listen to. Trying to use TMR on your own or by using YouTube videos or apps, the obvious risk is that you simply add a lot of background noise to your night's sleep, or that you end up listening to words and phrases that you haven't yet learned, which defeats the entire purpose. So, to sum this video up, no, you cannot learn a language in your sleep. Learning anything requires you to be awake. Sleeping does, however, help you remember things that you've already learned. And it might be possible to get a 10% retention boost from using TMR while you sleep, but it's not at all certain that it's a good idea to actually do it. My own personal take on this entire sleep learning business is this. I honestly understand why people want this to be a thing, but in the end, it is false hope. It is yet another case of people wanting to learn how to do something without actually doing it. Learning languages is like learning any other skill. It requires effort, and I think that when you stop hoping for magic and realize the correlation between what you put in and what you get out, that's when you can finally get started for real.